Hey farmers, what's going on? Welcome back to a very special Hey Dave video. So first of all, thank you very much guys for 5,000 subscribers. I am literally so shocked. I never thought that I would reach 5,000 subscribers this fast. This is so crazy. This is unbelievable. I can't believe this. It's crazy. Thank you so much guys. This really means a lot to me. I literally never thought that I would reach 5,000 subscribers on my YouTube channel this year. I was thinking that maybe it's just going to be 1,000, but this is crazy. I'm so grateful to all and every one of you, and it's just because if you guys were not there, probably would have never reached 5,000, and this is like half for the 10,000. It's a lot. For me, it's a lot, and I appreciate every single one of my subscribers, so it's really cool. Thank you so much, guys. So in this video, I'm also going to be talking about my journey as being a Haiti YouTuber or as being a person who Haiti videos. I'm going to be talking where I started, how I went, and what kind of difficulties I had to face to make videos and stuff like that. So I'm going to talk a lot in this video, and if you guys don't enjoy the commentary videos, you should probably not watch this, and otherwise just enjoy the video. So what I'm doing right now in the game, I have not been into my game. As you guys can see, there are so many things to do, which I'm going to be doing right now. So the first thing I did, I just sent away my boat and just got a blue vouchers. So for my next boat, I'm going to be needing some feta pies, potato soups, and the raspberry candle. So let me just collect all the products from my machines here first, and then I'm going to be starting preparing for my boat. So let me just go ahead and make some potato soups. All right, there we go. So you guys, a lot of you guys already know that I've been making videos almost every day for like a past few months. So I started my YouTube channel, I started making Haiti videos back in August 2016. There was a day I was really bored and I was like, I need to make a video. So I asked my brother that I want to make a video and he said, okay. So at that time, I literally did not used to have any information about the screen recorders, about editing or stuff like that. So I picked up my phone and then my brother recorded from his phone. So I played Haiti and he recorded it, and he forced me to make video in Urdu, which if you guys don't know is basically my main language because I live in Pakistan, so we speak Urdu here. But I wanted to make videos in English because I know a lot of people, you guys watch the videos, you speak English, and I know there are people from India and Pakistan that also watch my videos. But I wanted to make the videos in English because English is my favorite language. I've been learning English since I was a kid. English has been my favorite subject, and I know I'm not that good at English, but I'm trying, and I'm trying to improve my English every single day. So I talk a lot in English, and I think it's really cool. So yeah, that was my first video. I was on level 44. I posted it. I had about 0 subscribers at that time, and my channel name was called as Heyday Videos at that time. So I was bored, and I just created it. I got inspired from other Haiti content creators, and at that time there was no other creator than Ricky, so I think he was the only one. And there used to be some other people which I don't really remember now, but Ricky was like the main Haiti YouTuber at that time. There was no other. So he really inspired me to make my own channel. I used to watch his videos, I used to watch his streams, so that was really inspiring. And I created that channel. And at that time I used to be a school student, and I really didn't used to have a lot of time to do other stuff, so I used to post videos whenever I got time. I didn't used to post daily. I used to just post random videos without any editing or without anything. I would just record it from my phone and then I would upload it directly. And I know those videos are really cringy. I literally don't want to watch my old videos because I know how bad they are. But I'm so glad that I've actually changed a lot throughout these months. I've become better and my content has become better and my editing skills have gotten a little bit better. So yeah, I'm really improving and I hope to improve even more in the future. So basically, I did not give that much attention to my channel at that time. So I think I hit 100 subscribers back in August 2017. Then I hit 200 subscribers in September, I guess. And I also did not used to post daily. I only used to post once in a while, once after 5 to 6 months. If you guys watch my old videos, there are not a lot of videos. And then I remember I hit 400 subscribers in March 2018. I was really excited. That used to be really, really cool. And finally, 500 subscribers I hit in June 2018. I still remember that day. That day I got free from my exams, and I was so happy that I hit 500 subscribers, which was really cool for me. Honestly, even if I get like 10 subscribers, that's a lot for me. I really appreciate all of you guys subscribing. It really means a lot to me. So that was my journey till 500 subscribers. And then I hit 600 subscribers in December 2018. But at that time, I had stopped uploading because I got so busy. I got so indulged in my college work. I literally did not have any time to make videos. If you guys will watch my old videos, you will know that I literally didn't post anything for like 6 months. So my main challenge, my main comeback was in October 2019 when I got free. I came back. I had about 620 subscribers, and those were the subscribers from my previous year. I did not have any new subscribers, and I didn't even used to have people watching my videos. So I came back, and my main problem was that I didn't have my phone at that time. I had lost my phone last year, so I didn't have my phone. And another thing that I did not have a good screen recorder again. So I found a screen recorder, which I don't really know the name, but that was really bad. To record the screen as vertically, not horizontally. If you guys watch my previous Halloween videos, you will know what I'm talking about. So that was really annoying, but I couldn't do anything. I really wanted to make the videos, so I still kept on recording. So that was the main challenge. My videos did not used to get any views. They only used to get views like maybe like 10, 20. In 2 days, just 20 views, maybe 30 views. I didn't used to get a lot of likes. There was people disliking my videos. And also, previous years when I made my channel, I used to go ahead and send the links to my friends. I used to tell them that, hey, this is my channel. Can you please go ahead and subscribe? So they used to make fun of me. They said that, nah, we're not gonna subscribe your channel and shit. This is crazy, stuff like that. So I never really took those things to my heart because I loved what I was doing, so I just kept going on. So that was really hard. Until December 2019, my subscribers did not increase. My videos didn't get any views. I still used to post. So at the beginning of the December, something really magical happened, and that was I found Mobizen, which I currently use the screen recorder. I used to record my videos with Mobizen 3 years ago, but somehow it did not work on my phone. But in December, I finally got it back, and I was so happy. I literally exploded with happiness, and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna be starting making videos from now on. So I started recording the videos daily. On December 5th, I posted my first ever Correct Haiti video. That was like achievements and diamonds. And I literally got so determined. I was like, that now, from now on, I'm gonna post daily. So I started posting on daily, and my subscribers didn't used to increase. I had about 630 subscribers for like so many months, which was really demotivating because if a normal person, because if you see that you're not getting a lot of subscribers, people are not watching your videos, you feel demotivated, you feel bad, you feel like people don't enjoy your content, and you give up. But I really did not give up. I still kept going on because I knew you had to, you have to struggle a lot to achieve something. So yeah, that was like the most struggling part of me being a Haiti YouTuber. That was like so struggling, so hard, and but I still kept going on. So gradually my subscribers started increasing. I remember the first day I just got three more subscribers, and I was like, what? After so many months, three more subscribers, that's so cool. And that was like, I was really happy. And I used to post a lot of videos about my gameplays, about different aspects. I wanted to make videos that could be helpful for everybody. So in this game, there's so many things that people don't know. Like coins, XP, and expansion materials, these three things are like the heart of the farm. These things are like the main things in Haiti. So if you want to make videos on these things, that this can be really helpful for you. So if anyone of you is still struggling, or even if you make anything on YouTube, do not give up. That's all I say. Just keep doing whatever you're doing. Just keep going ahead. You will get what you deserve at the end. So don't worry about anything. So, I started making a lot of videos. My focus was always to make every single video, to make video on every single thing in the game. For example, on the town, on the fishing area, on the barn, on the silo, on the trucks. Like, I just wanted to make video on every single thing. I remember I even used to make like three videos in a single day because I was addicted. I was crazy. I was totally loving what I was doing. So yeah, I just kept going on, and then came January. February, those were really hard times because I didn't get any subscribers, like a lot. And then came March, April. So those were the times when my videos started getting a little bit viral. People started watching those like more often than previous. So that was really inspiring. And I also used to watch other Haiti YouTubers to get inspiration, because that's a good thing, of course. And I used to think a lot about different ideas. I used to search on YouTube that what kind of videos people are looking for Haiti. So I tried my best to make those videos like coins, XP, because these are the videos that people are always looking for, as you guys know, how to make coins and stuff like that. So yeah, this is how I kept going on. And at the beginning, it was really demotivating, but honestly, at the end, it was all worth it. So I hit my 1,000 subscribers in April 2020, which was just about, I think, 6 months ago. That was one of the best moments of this year. Like one of like the best memories ever. I literally screamed because I was so happy. Like I could not even imagine hitting 1,000 subscribers, but that was so cool. And I just kept going on again with my videos, and then I remember I hit 2,000 subscribers in July 2020. That was totally unexpected. Then I hit 3,000 in August, 4,000 in I think last month in September. And now I'm at 5,000, and this is so crazy how fast I'm going and how many people are supporting me now. It's just, you know what? I literally want to cry. Honestly, you guys are amazing. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for always supporting me and always watching the videos, always liking the videos, always commenting on my videos. That really means a lot to me. So I'm here just because of you guys, and I just want to say thank you so much again. It's all because of you guys, to be very honest. So yeah, that was my journey, and I'm sure it didn't come out well, and I know I talked a lot more than usual. And so yeah, I just wanted to say that, guys, whatever you're doing in your life, just keep going on. Do not give up. Giving up is not a solution, honestly. And even if you're trying to make videos on YouTube, they're not getting a lot of views, people are not watching your videos, don't worry, still keep going on. That's what I would like to say. And once again, thank you so much for 5,000 subscribers, and that really means a lot.
Yeah.